Bridgewater, just a giant hedge fund, right? Ray Dalio is where my mind goes. But when you hear that story about Mizuho, another sort of financial institution on a global scale, rolling out a generative AI tool to its employees, what do you think? You've been in this domain. You know how difficult it is.
Yeah, I think that it's a good question. So I think that generative AI does a lot of things for startups like, you know, I'm a serial entrepreneur doing these things, building products. I think that it has enabled us to do things that we otherwise weren't able to do at scale, but also brand new technologies. So like, we're, you know, Quivr is a series seed company. Like, we're a small group, we're just starting up. And you know, to be able to do the sort of generative AI, the natural language processing at scale that that you're able to do now with, you know, a simple API key is pretty unbelievable. And it's allowing us to do things that are was otherwise prohibited before.
We will get into Quivr in just a moment and talk about the specific use case that you're trying to crack. But when you left Bridgewater, did you consider developing an AI product or platform that could be used in the world of financial markets and financial institutions?
Yes, actually. So when I left, I also started working on trading algorithms of my own, mostly based in causal inference. And the biggest use case for generative AI, or really LLM models, is actually the synthesis of the amount of data that you have to crunch in order to try to understand the market, right? And being able to do that, again, like I said, being able to do that at scale is a thing that has really only become available and possible in, say, the last few years.
So Quivr, let's get into it. The primary artificial intelligence use case is to protect the badging process. Well, yes. What is the badging process?
That's right. So Quivr is, we're trying to do something a little different with digital identity. I think that people tend to think about digital identity as like a KYC, know your customer, you know, what's your social security number, what's your driver's license, where do you live, this kind of stuff. And instead, what we wanted to do is focus on the more human aspects of our identity and create a platform where people can aggregate all of these different facets they have on different platforms right now. You know, your music preferences might sit on Spotify. Maybe your lifestyle preferences are sitting in somewhere in some collection of Instagram photos and Twitter tweets and things like this. And we wanted to create a space where you could bring all of that together and represent yourself more holistically. And of course, not, you know, the things that make us most interesting are often not online at all. And so the question is, how do you bring that online and how do you get that validated? And so we have this social protocol that allows people to create videos and submit evidence that gets voted on by the community. And you get validated for that way too. So for example, if you're a dog lover, like, there's probably not, you know, that's a silly thing, but it's a big aspect of our humanity, right? So when you put that next to, say, your accolades and, you know, you worked at Bridgewater, but you're also a dog lover, it makes you more human. And I think a big part that is missing in the internet is that aspect of our humanity. And so that's what we're trying to do. And then, of course, our AI use case there is, this is obviously very delicate, right? We need a lot of trust in this space. And so, again, going back to like things like agent models and AI, it allows us to do, to protect that authenticity and that validation process at scale in a way that was completely impossible even 6 months ago.
Joseph, I'm almost certain that a big portion of the Bloomberg Technology audience are dog lovers. It's okay. It's not silly. It's built on graph AI algorithms. Explain the underlying technology to me. What is the point of difference there on a graph AI algorithm?
Yeah, so what we have is a sort of graph that connects all of the users and their interests and their likes. And then what we can do in that is do community detection. We can look at fraud detection. We can look at if there are bad actors in the community or if there's a group of people that are sort of taking over some sort of some you know niche of the badge like library, if you will. If there's things like prejudice, if there's things like, you know, people trying to you know, discriminate in systematic ways, the graph allows us to suss that out and see and detect these bad actors.